Make it happen. Make it happen. Call it to you. Get your relationship all with this moody young lady.
Hugs, 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 hugs.
Let's go, Pule.
Ice. First one down on the bottom. Push it. It's been honestly one of the better years of my life. Not just the contest, just being home, being with family, surfing with friends, and being able to surf in front of my family and kind of just show them what I do, especially some of the family that never gets to see me surf.
Finals with John Florence. Feeling pretty good. I haven't really like had that heat of my life yet. I mean, my first round is pretty good, but I feel like it doesn't really count until those man-to-man heats. Other than that, it's been a great comp. I've been golfing every day. Literally been surfing my heats and going golfing. Surfing my heats and going golfing. I mean, pipe's such a dangerous wave, so it's kind of hard to like practice out there like when you're in the middle of a comp. Don't really want to get hurt, so. Come out here, play, get my mind off surfing and like just not thinking about it.
Fucking set, boy.
I remember being there at the beach that day. It was just goosebumps every time he paddled out. And just everyone on the beach, his whole support crew, was just super, super sick to see. And I was just glad I was there. Just got to watch on the beach and just be one of his boys, you know, supporting him. Honestly, I went down and the only heat I wanted to watch was the John heat with John. John is like the highest level of surfing pipe, and I feel like Seth is right there with him, so I just wanted to see them battle it out. For one time, I felt like John was worried about someone else in the heat at pipe rather than just himself, and it kind of took him out of his whole element of competing out there, and you could just tell from the very first wave, Seth put the pressure on him and got that 9 under his priority, and just it was on. So after that first wave that Seth got, I felt like John was kind of chasing and coming from behind. And Seth just had him on the ropes, and Seth just took it right to him. It was super sick to see. I think the turning point in that heat was when John knew Seth only needed one more good wave to kind of get back in the lead. And John was just trying to out-position Seth and just worried about him, and kind of made a bad decision and went on one right, ate shit, broke his board, and left Seth out there with 5 minutes left and one more chance. And to me, I was like, it's over. Seth's gonna get that wave and he's gonna do it. And he did, and it was probably the sickest thing I ever seen. I'm getting goosebumps right now just even thinking about it, but it was sick. I was just super stoked for Seth boy. And yeah, see, even he knows.
I mean, I think that was like my most nerve-wracking heat I've ever had with John. I was like, I was so nervous. Heart was racing. So I had like crazy anxiety. Like I couldn't like control my heart rate. It was just like pumping out of my chest. But I feel like that, like every time that happens, when I have crazy like anxiety, I feel like I do good. That heart rate gets you up, and I don't know. That was like one of the better heats of my life right there, because I felt like I won the comp after. I swear I was like, oh, did I win? But no, I didn't. Obviously had the heat with Kyle, and I knew when I pouted out for that heat, and I seen Kelly he made the semi, and Kelly yelled at me like, do it, make smart decisions, like don't get greedy. So I knew he wanted me in the final with him. And the guys were rushing me to come in after the semi to grab my jersey, and then they were rushing me to get back out. And once I got in the water, it was on, I was psyched. I told Kelly to give me everything. Like I told him I wanted his best, and I think he got super amped when I said that, and I kind of seen a fire in his eyes, and I think that might have been the worst mistake of my life. After finally making a wave, I got my first real score. I got a 9. But after that, I I didn't really have the correct time on my watch because I started the timer a little late after the horn blew. But I knew I had like just enough time to get out back into the lineup if the ski grabbed me quick enough. And it was pretty cool because it was a full battle, like it was a full ski battle, like who was going to get out. Basically, once I got into the lineup, I didn't realize, but there was only 10 seconds left. I was just thinking of the heats that Kelly flipped in the last 3 minutes, and I think he's done it a few times at pipe, so it's never end until the horn's over at pipeline.
It's a special day. It's hard to talk right now because I don't even know how I feel, really. I can't even, like, it doesn't even really feel like I was there standing up on the podium with him. It just feels like, it just feels weird. It doesn't feel normal. It's pretty baffled. Like, I got to share, like, I was, like, crying with Kelly Slater in the lineup, and I was so happy for him. Like, obviously, I wouldn't have want to lose to anyone else besides him. It's just super special. I hope it's his last heat so I can kind of have that claim. But I don't know. I'm pretty happy. Second place, first comp of the year. Last year I got dead last. And then last year I lost in the first three events. And now I'm second in the world right now. So, pretty baffled.
Straight into Sunset Beach, 4 days later after the pipe finals. I felt like I haven't even done a turn for years. I was just grabbing my rail and going straight. It was really fun, it was challenging, and after coming off super high, it was definitely tough to kind of contain that and just focus on the next heat because none of that mattered anymore. My final with Kelly, all those points, that shit didn't matter anymore, so. Definitely seemed like this winter the tide switched and the new generation was definitely making a move to kind of just show their presence. And losing to Baron definitely sucked because I feel like just anytime I come up against like someone from home, you definitely want to beat them because, I mean, even though we all train together and root for each other, it's just like, it's just bragging rights for us. And I'm definitely stoked Baron's on tour now and he won the comp, and we're definitely going to have many more battles in the future.
Show was nuts. Show was mental. Seth, I'm glad you're in one piece, bro. The level of performance, Seth, was so high that you had your whole family, all your support crew, jumping through the roof. And everybody is so proud of you for becoming what we all knew you were capable of. Very proud of you.
Well, Brad and Seth really stepped it up today. Beat John Florence with big scores in the quarterfinals. Very exciting heat. Very inspiring for all of us, all of his friends and family. So, yeah, he gave us a good show, which is why we're all here for the show. So, yeah, it was fun to watch and to see it all go down firsthand, be hanging out with him at the house and eating ice cream every night, and then see him go out and just school guys. That's what it's all about. Have fun and school guys. I think we were getting Ben and Jerry's. I'm not sure what flavor he got, but I got peanut butter with Oreo. It's a pretty good combo. I think it helps with a little extra carbs for the three heats in one day. This morning, Seth was thinking, oh, should I go free surf before the comp? And I was like, nah, you're going to have three heats today. You got to save your energy. And good thing, because he took some big beatings. Looked like a UFC fight out there. I don't know how he's all right now. He's still going. I think he's got lots of energy just riding off everyone else. But Yeah, Seth will always be going.